This is Nowhere Certain, a Harley Cole Mystery, Book 7. Written by Kate Bold. Narrated by Reagan Tankersley. Prologue. Victoria Bond's heart had never beat so fiercely in all her life. As she clung to the rock face, her fingers aching and cold sweat trickling down her ribcage, she tried to ignore the panicked voice in her head telling her she couldn't keep climbing. The truth was she had no choice. If she let go, she would fall, and though the distance was short enough that she might survive with little more than a twisted ankle, there was a greater danger than the ground waiting for her below. He was down there. And he didn't let her forget about him either. As she hesitated, her body trembling with tension like a tuning fork, a rock clattered against the stone wall close to her head, the sound so startling that she nearly let go.
"Hey!" he shouted. "What do you think this is, a picnic? Get moving, fat ass!"
The problem was, she didn't know where to go. Her fingers were going numb, as were her calves, and the sheer cliff face offered no place to rest her aching muscles and catch her breath. She would have to climb another 40 or 50 feet, a task that seemed utterly impossible at the moment, before she reached the top. And to add to the difficulty, as if she needed the additional challenge, the sun had just set, and the color was slowly draining from the sky, leaving a steely gray that shed only the palest of light on the cliff face.
"What did I do to deserve this?" she thought miserably. "What did I do wrong? I've always tried to be a good person. How did I end up here?"
"If you don't get moving,"
the man shouted in a voice of cold command, "the next rock hits your spine. Trust me, I won't miss." Victoria had no interest in putting him to the test. Energized by this threat, she strained to pull herself upward, her hands blindly searching the rock face for purchase. Her fingers caught a small ledge, and she moved upward, foot by foot, dragging herself up the wall like an injured spider. She didn't know what she would find when she reached the top, but she did know what she would do. She would run, as hard and as fast as she could. If she got lost, so be it. Better to be lost and alone than to be his plaything. Yes, that was the word for it. He was a cat, and she was his new toy. And apparently his idea of fun was to force her to climb up this rock wall.
"Maybe he wants me to fall," she thought. "Maybe that's the whole idea. He knows I can't do it, so he'll spur me on until I collapse."
Of course, it all made sense now. She would fall to her death, and it would look like an unfortunate accident. Investigators would think she'd gotten a sudden hankering for rock climbing, and she'd come out here dressed in jeans and a ruffled blouse because... No. The more she thought about it, the more apparent it became that if she fell, nobody would think for a second it had been an accident. Investigators would immediately suspect foul play. Didn't the man below her realize that? A rock exploded beside her, shards of stone biting into her arm. She screamed, and one hand slipped, only managing to find another hold at the last moment.
"You stopped again," the man, her tormentor, called. "Do you think I can't see you?"
As if to demonstrate how exposed she was, a beam of light suddenly glowed all around her. Apparently, he'd brought a flashlight.
"I can't do it,"
she cried out, overcome with shame and fear. Her voice shook, and she felt a great, heavy sob working its way up from her chest. If it reached her mouth, she was not sure what would happen. Would she just break down and let go? What would he do to her if she fell?
"You know the answer to that," a cold voice answered. "He will finish what he started. That's what he'll do. Your only chance is to get to the top of the cliff and then run for all you're worth."
She wasn't sure how much gas she'd have left in the tank by the time she reached the top of the wall, assuming she achieved that miracle. But she did know she was going to use all of it, even if it meant running on fumes. With a sudden burst of determination, she gritted her teeth.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.